Humans have long been masters of dexterity, a skill that can largely be credited to the help of our eyes. Robots, meanwhile, are still catching up. Certainly, there has been some progress. For decades, robots in controlled environments like assembly lines have been able to pick up the same object over and over again. More recently, breakthroughs in computer vision have enabled robots to make basic distinctions between objects. But even then, they don't truly understand objects' shapes, so there is little they can do after a quick pickup. In a new paper, researchers from MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory, CSAIL, say that they have made a key development in this area of work, a system that lets robots inspect random objects and visually understand them enough to accomplish specific tasks without ever having seen them before. The system, dubbed Dense Object Nets, DONN, looks at objects as collections of points that serve as visual roadmap of sorts. This approach lets robots better understand and manipulate items, and most importantly, allows them to even pick up a specific object among a collector of similar objects, a valuable skill for the kinds of machines that companies like Amazon and Walmart use in their warehouses. For example, someone might use DONN to get a robot to grab onto a specific spot on an object, say the tongue of a shoe. From that, it can look at a shoe it has never seen before and successfully grab its tongue. Many approaches to manipulation can't identify specific parts of an object across the many orientations that object may encounter. For example, existing algorithms would be unable to grasp a mug by its handle, especially if the mug could be in multiple orientations like upright or on its side. The team views potential applications not just in manufacturing settings, but also in homes. Imagine giving the system an image of a tidy house and letting it clean while you are at work, or using an image of dishes so that the system puts your plates away while you are on vacation. What is also noteworthy is that none of the data was actually labeled by humans. Rather, the system is self-supervised, so it doesn't require any human annotations. Two common approaches to robot grasping involve either task-specific learning or creating a general grasping algorithm. These techniques both have obstacles. Task-specific methods are difficult to generalize to other tasks, and general grasping doesn't get specific enough to deal with the nuances of particular tasks like putting objects in specific spots. The DONN system, however, essentially creates a series of coordinates on a given object which serve as a kind of visual roadmap of the object to give the robot a better understanding of what it needs to grasp and where. The team trained the system to look at objects as a series of points that make up a larger coordinate system. It can then map different points together to visualize an object's 3D shape, similar to how panoramic photos are stitched together from multiple photos. After training, if a person specifies a point on an object, the robot can take a photo of that object and identify and match points to be able to then pick up the object at that specified point. This is different from systems like UC Berkeley's DexNet, which can grasp many different items but can't satisfy a specific request. Imagine an infant at 18 months old who doesn't understand which toy you wanted to play with but can still grab lots of items, versus a 4-year-old who can respond to "go grab your truck by the red end of it." In one set of tests done on a soft caterpillar toy, a Kuka robotic arm powered by DONN could grasp the toy's right ear from a range of different configurations. This showed that, among other things, the system has the ability to distinguish left from right on symmetrical objects. When testing on a bin of different baseball hats, DONN could pick out a specific target had, despite all of the hats having very similar designs and having never seen pictures of the hats in training data before. In the future, the team hopes to improve the system to a place where it can perform specific tasks with a deeper understanding of the corresponding objects, like learning how to grasp an object and move it, with the ultimate goal of, say, cleaning a desk.